Today we speak with Olivier Le Peuch, CEO of Schlumberger, about oil markets, emerging technologies, and strategic choices. I am Mesh Al-Kindi, and this is ADNOC Insights. Welcome to ADNOC Insights, Olivier.
Thank you very much.
So you were recently appointed as CEO of Schlumberger. What are your immediate priorities?
The vision that I've set forward for the company is about performance, driving industry performance to a new level. And this doesn't mean Schlumberger performance, but our customer performance. Our customer and ADNOC, amongst others, are challenged to operate and improve the return to shareholders and make the basin in which where they operate more resilient. So our opportunity at Schlumberger is to combine our team performance, our technology, and to align with our customer performance gap and to create a new benchmark for the industry, to elevate the benchmark of performance in the industry and to create a market outperformance. This is, if anything, is my first and utmost priority.
So we've seen quite volatile oil markets recently. How do you see the market developing in the medium term?
Medium term, I think we are seeing a shift in the market dynamics. I believe that the geopolitical situation that we live, some of the regional and supply dynamics are creating a new regional supply-demand dynamics that is getting basin activity to diverge. There are four major basins in the world that I believe will define the future of activity, from North America land to Russia or Central Asia to Middle East and to offshore. Each and every of these basins is competing for resilience, for performance, and that's where we believe that elevating and addressing fit-for-basin solution for performance in each of these basins will make the industry more resilient and will help address this the future of energy mix.
And how do these dynamics affect your strategic choices and the direction going forward?
So I believe that as this dynamic is happening, I think as this basin are looking for resilience, for competitiveness, we believe that focusing on performance, understanding the gaps of performance every basin, are critical to the customer success. So what we want to do is to create fit for basin solution so that every customer in every basin as an opportunity to outperform and to create a new benchmark for the industry. So fit-for-basin solution and digital solution, so that digital being a step change, it can bring a step change in our customer performance, and we believe we have some solution. So combining fit-for-basin, digital, I believe we can create a unique performance in every basin for every operator.
As the industry implements new solutions in automation and machine learning, are we changing our business model accordingly?
I think we must. Digital is a unique opportunity to create a leap, again, in performance. No doubt about this, it's recognized, everybody is embracing digital transformation. But I think it's not about technology only, it's about changing the business model. But first, I think it starts with open foundation. Without open foundation in digital, we will, as an industry, not realize the full value of digital transformation. So creating for the industry, across an industry, a digital open foundation is the first attribute of success. By this, we can then scale, we can then have partners and operators all accelerating digital innovation and creating the change and the success they need. So if we do that, then there will be multiple models. First, the digital models, software as a service, digital products, digital transaction, or a subscription-based activity and digital services that you can provide as an industry. I think that's certainly the most that will happen. But next, I think is more interestingly for the industry, is once we have this and we have digital enablers, is to start to create a performance model where multiple partners or operators and service company work towards achieving a performance step change in an asset, in a field development or into a producing asset. And then the performance value that is created is shared and hence create a new incentive to invest digital solution for this industry.
In your view, what are the top three emerging technological trends that can really make a difference in the industry?
First, and obviously, I think digital. I think applying machine learning, artificial intelligence to reservoir characterization particularly, to prepare the next well and learn from the last well and make sure that the next well is better than last, and using digital insight, I think is unique. And I think you can apply this to geosounds, or you can apply this to operation and implement automation. So digital on data sounds and digital on edge automation, I think, is the first. The second one, I think, is electric, going full electric. I think as an industry, we could, and we have not developed, and we have not transformed the industry, and we could go subsea, full electric, we call it electric completion, electric actuation, and intervene electrically our wells and our operation. If we do so, digital will not only be natural and will be only a natural enabler for the digital electric operation. So I think that's... And the last, I think, that could transform and change the way the industry is perceived is if the industry was to address the carbon capture and participate in contributing not only to sequestration, but also to carbon capture, and making sure that we contribute and we use carbon capture and energy storage solutions. So carbon capture or energy storage were to prepare the future contribution of our industry to the energy landscape.
If I may add, how prepared do you think we are as an industry to take on these three top trends that you just mentioned?
I don't think we are prepared for digital. I think digital is a little bit of a hype today. There is a foundation that exists now in digital that allows all operators and all partners to operate on the same platform, open data exchange platform on the cloud. So that's the first step. So we are ready technically. Are we ready in the business model? I think we need to accept to work in an industry as partners and not only as one operator and one service company and one provider. So I think we need to accept to work openly in partnership and so that we can unlock the digital value.
Olivier, thank you so much for coming and sharing your valuable insights.
Thank you. Thank you very much. You're welcome.